am I afraid to step out and try something new because I'm after 50 and I'm not sure? And what if I fail? Or what if I not don't like this? Or what if, what if, what if, what if? Well, you know what I always say. Should is shit. Get it out of your vocabulary.
Did you push record?
Thank you so much for tuning into our second act with Paige and Silke.
For your second act of life. Hey, Silke.
Hi, Paige. I'm glad to see you. You look so happy, which is what we're going to talk about today.
That was good.
It's chasing happiness. And we're using the word chasing because a lot of us at this time in our lives, and we've gotten a lot of viewer comments on some of the previous segments we've recently done, half of our life is over. We haven't accomplished what we wanted to do. And we're discouraged and we're unhappy. Why does it seem like we're struggling with happiness at this point in our life, maybe more so than before?
Well, I think this is divine timing that we're doing this now, especially after the suicides of Kate Spade and Anthony Bourdain. Because when you look at their life, you would think from the outside, they have it all. They've got money, they've got family, they've got fame, they've got this, and this. And it just shows you that you can have all those things and still not be happy. So today we wanted to kind of talk about, you know, when these kind of things happen in the media, a lot of people reevaluate their own lives. Where am I? My gosh, am I happy? What can I do for myself to make myself more happy? Am I afraid to step out and try something new because I'm after 50 and I'm not sure? And what if I fail? Or what if I don't like this? Or what if, what if, what if, what if? Well, you know what I always say. Should is shit. Get it out of your vocabulary. So it's all about chasing happiness. How do you find it? What I have seen is it's in the small things that can be cumulative, that can make you feel happy. So each day, what makes you happy? Like Silke, what made you happy today?
It made me happy that I got to see you today, that we're doing this interview. No, I get what you're saying. I get what you're saying. I go to it maybe a little bit deeper, I reflect on especially Anthony Bourdain. I mean, here's somebody that we've talked about, you know, what, yeah, we want to show like his. We want to try. He's been like not a mentor by any means, but somebody to aspire to. And for him to take his own life, that shook me up as it did so many other people who are now reflecting on their lives.
Yeah, and there's no solid go-to answer for what's going to make you happy. It is a journey through this life, and it's not a sprint, it's a marathon. You know, Silke, that I'm a shaman as well. And in the world of shamanic healing, when you look at animals, and I'm going to take the hummingbird. You know, we use the hummingbird in shamanic healing because the hummingbird is the only bird that can fly backwards. And shamanically, hummingbird can fly back, so you can go back and look at what's gone on in your life and pull things out that work for you. You don't have to keep staying in that place. The hummingbird is also here to remind us to grab the joy when you have it. Because as we get older, more things occur, more things happen. So, you know, one of the biggest tips that I have is staying in the moment, that when you have a joyful moment or a joyful hour or a joyful day or a joyful weekend, soak it in, suck it up, take it for everything that it is, and just enjoy that, because that is part of happiness. While maybe you're reevaluating your life and saying, what do I want to try that might bring me more joy? And I'm going to walk through my fear, no matter how scared I am, to step out and try it. These are all, you know, good tips to what is happiness for you.
Yeah, well, it's great, and it makes me smile when you're talking about it, because you know, another thing that we're going to talk about soon is that you and I want to try something new that we haven't done before to encourage other people, you know, to do. What did you call it?
What I called is I got it off of you remember the group Hootie and the Blowfish, and their lead singer Darius Rucker is now a country singer, and he has this great song that's called. When was the last time you did something for the first time? And I called you and I said, Silke, we need to do this for all the people out there who are afraid to do something for the first time after 50. And we need to show everyone, hey, look at all these things that you can start to do for the first time. So, you know, I pose that question to our viewers. When was the last time you've done something for the first time? And we're going to have a series on there that they're going to watch you and I do things for the first time. I know I've already started. So that's another way of bringing potential happiness. So look at the possibilities of what you can do that brings you happiness. Not, oh my God, if it doesn't work, or what if I don't do this? No.
And I love that, the possibilities, because I know when we talked about this, I was kind of down on myself that day. I didn't really feel very good, and that's kind of when you came up with that, and it invigorated me. It was like, this would be so much fun. So I, you know, and that I think that's a key also to finding happiness. Certainly for me is, gosh, be able to laugh and have fun.
Yes. Yes.
You know, comedy may not, I mean, they say that, you know, some of the comedians are the saddest people on earth, but there's something about laughter that's got to make you feel better, right?
Absolutely. And even if you try something and it doesn't turn out the way you want, but you're laughing through it, you at least did it. You tried something new and you crawled out of your box, and then that opens up for other things to try for a path of potential happiness. So try and look at it that way. You know, as well too, that there's so many things after 50 that we've never done for the first time. So don't rule us out that after 50, because there's many things still out there. And, you know, as I say that, I think as we get older, sometimes we think, well, what are the new firsts? What are the new adventures? Am I going to have any more new firsts, or have any more new adventures? And I'm here to say, hell yes, there are new firsts and new adventures. So when was the last time you did something for the first time?
Well, and, you know, I'm about, I'm right before my 60th. So I can certainly tell viewers that if you're just crossing that 50, oh my gosh, talk about a bunch of new firsts. And it was invigorating, and it was incredible. So Paige, is there anything that you want to leave our viewers with before we close out this segment?
Yeah, with some hope that after 50 doesn't mean you're done. After 50 means, okay, what are the new adventures? What are the new firsts that I haven't experienced yet that maybe I will take in and be grateful for more, really feel it more? Because when you're 20s and you experience stuff, oh, it's great, let's do this and this. But when you're in your 50s and you experience, there's more of a soaking in of really taking all your fiber, all your fluids, just everything. So just know that, start beginning to think about, when was the last time you did something for the first time? And let's start creating some firsts of possibilities of happiness in your life after 50.
Paige, I can't wait to start doing that with you. So let's get that date, and let's do something for the first time.
That sounds great, Silka.
Okay, we'll see you next time on Our Second Act with Paige and Silka.
For your second act of life.
Thanks for joining us. I hope you found this information helpful. If you haven't already done so, please just take 1 second and subscribe to our channel. Button's right over here. And for more information about living your life to the fullest after 50, visit our website, secondact.tv. See you soon.